Hi everyone, today we will create game over condition and using lives that we already made before, or of course with new asset. Basically it's like this: start game, this is our lives and this is our score. When we touch the ground and not scored, the lives minus by 1, and when we score, of course it's not minus, okay? And when we game over, it shows our final score and then a retry button, and the lives also become zero again. That's it. Let's start. Okay, so we already know that we want the layout that is the score is on the left and the lives on the right. So we can adjust the score position first, go to canvas, score text, and set the anchor, pivot, and also the position. So press shift alt and press this top left. Okay. And now you see that the position X is changing, width is changing, and there's width and height, okay? We will set it height as 0 for now. So it will set the original position. The width, I don't think we need more than 200 pixel or unit. And position X, we can set it as 0 first. This is a text and we set it center alignment, so we can set it to left alignment. Now we can give a margin. Position X is 50 and then position Y is minus 50 because we're going down, not up. Okay, like that. Now our score position is done. We can import our lives control. Let's load our custom package. Right click, import package and custom package. This is what we make before, so if you haven't watched it, please watch it first. I will put the link in the description. Press open. Here, choose all, import, done. And this is the folder, open it. We can use the lives container, drag it into the canvas. It's already using the right position that we make before, but we need to change it into minus 50 for position X and minus 50 for position Y. Okay, let's see this first, the value we want using 3 lives. For now, let's using spacing 20, width and height 100, okay? Press play, we will see how it looks. Okay, like that. It's bad, right? We need to find an asset for this. Okay, stop it. Go to free pick, find hard. I will use this one. And I already edited it, so it will become transparent. Next, go to our Unity, drag our hard. And this is our heart. See, it's transparent and the size is 100 by 83. So next we need to create the live revamp. Right click on canvas, UI, raw image, and then on texture we can drag this heart. Let's see. Okay, it stretched because the height is not right. Let's set it 83, like that. Okay, so this is our revamp. Give name live2, because we already have live here, and then make it into a prefab, remove it from the editor, and then go to lives container, set our height into our lives object, so 83. We don't care about the width because we make it automatically, basically the height too, but anyway, let's go here and set the width 100 and height 83. Okay, let's see. Now we change the live object prefab into our new live2. Okay, let's test it first. Okay, it's changing. Good, right? Next, we want to set when it touched the ground and it's not scored, then minus the lives by 1. Okay, let's start by when it touched the ground, then minus the lives by 1. Go to our script. This is our game system. And if we see the list, we already have this new one, lives control. So let's open it. How to control the lives control here? How to call it? It's easy. Basically, we can just put a variable here and set it into lives control. Okay. Then we can declare here serialize field private lives control, just like that. And it will show up in Unity Editor, our game system. And this is our new lives control. Drag lives container. OK, Okay, it's automatically detect our script. Go here, and then when it touches the ground, see where is when it, basically on respawn.
Yep.
Because on ground event, respawn ball, okay? So we start here. When it respawn the ball, then lives control dot lose life. Okay, let's try this. Maybe I will put it here so it will become bigger. Play. Okay, let's touch the ground. Okay, the life's minus one, right? And when it's over, it will reset the lives because we make it that way before. Okay, good. Now we need to check if when we score like this, touch the ground, and it's not removing the lives, okay? We'll get back our script. In here, we got score when we score, so we can create variable is scored false. When we score, then it changing to true, like that. And here, when we respond the ball, we can check it if is score, or maybe if not is score, if not scoring, then lives control lose lives, right? And then don't forget to reset the state is score equals false, so you can check again. Okay, let's try play. Okay, compiler error. Ah, typo is scored. Okay, start the game. Okay, lose life still working. And when it scores, it doesn't decrease. Again, decrease. Good. Next, when the life is over, we want to show the game over screen, right? So this is our start screen, this panel, right? So we can duplicate this and name it game over panel. I think I should name it like this. And we can change the text. Oh, change this to game over group. Title, let's say game over, just like that. And the button text is retry, just like we planned before. Okay, so this is starting with active false, so it won't show on start, but we want to show it when game over, right? The problem is we make this game over using Unity event, and we want to access the game over from the game system. So we need to add new event using Unity action here. Let's name it on game over event, just like that. And we add it here when the game over or when the lives is zero. So on game over event.info, just like that. And then here we need to set on game over event. So create a method here, maybe below the start game. Private void on game over. Then for now, just print game over so we know it works. In awake, we need to set the lives control dot on game over event plus the event is on game over. So it will direct the game over event calling this function. I already make tutorial about this too in the previous chapter, so I will provide the link in the video description. Okay, maybe now we can check it if it's work or not. Get back to our Unity editor. Play it. Start. Okay, it's detecting our game over. It's great. Okay, nice. Now we need to show the game over panel. The easiest way is put this game over panel into our game system so we can activate it from the game system, okay? Let's try. Serialize field. Private game object. Game over screen. Let's name it like that. And on game over, we can show it game over screen dot set active true. Go to editor. In our game system, just drag this into our game over screen and play it. Let's test it. Start game, game over, and yes, it's showing up, and if we press retry, it becomes two ball. Nice. Anyway, we already halfway. We need to prevent the ball respawn on that game over. The problem is we don't know which one is running first, game over first or this respawn ball. And there's a process when creating object and it's not finished, so we can't detect it better. What I found is we can just remove the respawn ball if the state is game over. So it's like this. Private boolean is game over equals false, right? And then when game over, we set it game over true. And here on respawn ball, we can create new method. So outside the respawn ball here, remember when we spawn the ball, we create on ground event plus respawn ball. So we can add more event after this, like this, ball command on ground event plus equal check game over. Okay, so if we create here private void check game over, if is game over, then destroy the ball like that. And when we start the game again here, we want to set the game over is false again. Okay, let's try. Start it. Okay, nice. The ball is gone now. Retry and the ball again. Yeah, it's working well. Good. Nice. Now we just need to create the final score, right? So let's activate it again. Go to our scene. And here we can copy the title, drag it into the middle, name it final score. And then the text is score, let's say like this. And maybe we can drag it to the top. Yeah, I think this is better. Okay, deactivate it again. And again, we choose the easiest way for a simple project. So we will add the final score text into the game system. Open our script. We don't need this, so we close. And here, serialized field, private TMP text, final score text. So the format is like this. Okay. Just create a function for this, private void, final score. Sorry, show final score. Maybe it should be set final score. Then final score dot set text equal to score dot what score dot to string. So we put it when game over screen set active true. Then yeah, like this. Just call it. Go to the editor. Final score does not exist in the current context. Okay, yeah, wrong name. Add text there. Again, go to our game system, drag the final score. Okay, little adjustment. So the set text become score. Let's play. Try this. Score 0. Okay, retry. Let's make some score. Score 1. Okay, now the next problem is our score still 1, right? So we need to reset the score 2. So on start game, set the score to 0 again. That's it. Easy. Okay, now let's try. Okay, score 2 and retry. Why is still 2? Basically, it's not. Let's see. 0, right? But we didn't update the text. So let's update it. Score and set is like this. And you should already knew that it's done. But we need to refactor something like this into a function. Private void set score. Put this code here. and let the other using this method like that. Now it fixed. Let's try. Okay, retry and it's 0, okay? That's it. Do you enjoy this tutorial? If yes, please like and press subscribe. Okay, next maybe we will try it into an Android maybe. See you in the next video.